Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Secretary Holtz, for being with us today. Share your testimony. We'll be looking forward to the second battle. I have some feeling that there's going to be some disagreement between your assessment and theirs on the availability of workers. But we'll get at that. I appreciate your testimony today. I know that you're not the Assistant Secretary for the Wage and Hour Division, but there's been some discussion about H-2A workers not having protections. And I would argue that under the DOL, it appears that quite a few, and I'm looking at a print from the DOL's website where it says that, for example, no later than the time at which an H-2A worker applies for a visa, no later than the first day of work, the workers in corresponding employment, the employer must provide each worker a copy of the work contract that must be available to them. It talks about the hours, the start and end dates, and so forth. You've got a guarantee to all workers employment for a total number of hours equal to at least 75% of the work days of the contract period. You've got to provide housing, you've got to provide transportation, you have to provide contract wages, you have to provide inbound and outbound expenses. All these supervised by wage and hour in the Department of Labor. So to suggest that there are no protections is just inaccurate. Let's get to your we're going to hear an independent second panel, and it's a little bit of a disadvantage for you here because you're testifying in person. You haven't had a chance to hear from them. Some testimony that says in 15 years from 1995 to 2009, the average number of employer appeals to administrative law judges regarding the H-2A applications was about 18. This year, there have already been 442. Appeals filed. And testimony again later will reveal that the department is prevailing in only 10% of these appeals. How do you explain the spike in essentially the department losing 90% of the appeals? Is that right? Do you agree with those numbers?
I don't have the accurate numbers in front of me, Mr. Chairman, but I will certainly get them to you. But I mean, I think, look, 18 to 442, I'm not going to defend that. That's difficult. What I am going to say to you is that any time a new rule is promulgated, there are more appeals because people are getting used to the change. But I think if those numbers are correct, it's indefensible, and we need to work with this committee to get those down.
Not only is there a spike, a huge spike, 18,442. You're only winning 10% of the time, so it's not like these are spurious or dilatory. These are genuine appeals to administrative law judges that the department is losing. Even you have that kind of spike, I would argue that you are having a worse than shedding, a freezing effect across the industry and across the country. And this is a time when we're worried about jobs. We'll hear again in testimony about the effect of when a company is put in this position and you've got crops that fail in the field, it's not just H-2A workers who suffer from this, it's the American workers suffering as well. If a company goes under because of this, it does damage to American workers and not just to H-2A visa workers. Again, we're going to have testimony addressing some of these issues, but it seems to me, when we look at some of the testimony we're going to hear, that only 5% of U.S. workers found that workforce agencies actually work through the entire contract period. Those that come, they try it for a few days, they try it for a week, decide it's too hard or something, and then they leave. And something else is 70% of U.S. workers don't accept the agricultural job offered to them. So there's an enormous amount of pressure here. And again, one of my friends and colleagues, the aforementioned Baylor Minister, is here from Minnesota to testify to this, and so I don't want to jump ahead to his testimony. But at a time when the economy is struggling as bad as this one is, and I don't think anybody denies that it's in trouble, and we have high joblessness, and you've got a department that is causing this kind of disruption where you have 442 appeals when we used to have 18, you're causing great distress in the system. So I heard your offer to work here. I hope that we can count on you to do that. I'm certainly going to encourage all of my constituents who are running this problem to start that dialogue. It's a big problem, and I think we can do something about it if we'll work together. I'm sorry, I've exceeded my time. I yield back.
Thank you.